Page after Honor Mate. El Page driving it. Honor Mate missed him. Honor Mate. Honor Mate's beaten El Page. Third a photo. Skinner's Regret zipped home. Colonial Flame closer to the rail. Then Star Council, Belle de Savoir, followed by Macon Time and No Sir.
8-4 and a photo on a mate. The former New South Wales pace of the winner for Robbie Martin. Wentworth Park, back of the boxes. 1 minute to bet. Ray Conroy. Look at the four.
Run. Carolyn Bale jumped away well and going to the lead on settling down. Silver Brute, the leader, but pushing through Imposing Cave, going it now, has gone to the lead there, followed then by National Dinigan, Mickey Milo on the rail, and a fair way back to Pompeii Governor. Admiral Sam, second last now, is cruising, and back at the tail now is Carolyn Bale, out of the back straight up to the turn now, and the leader showing the way. Imposing Cape led around the turn for Mickey Milo. Mickey Milo rattling home. Imposing Cape, beat Mickey Milo. Third placing in the event went to National Dinigan. They're followed home by Silver Brute. And the next to finish, Admiral Sam cruising and Carolyn Bale with Pompeii Governor in front of that, about the last to finish.
Race 8 at Wentworth Park as called by Ray Conroy. 3-1 and 2. Ray tipping the winner there, Imposing Cape. The superfecta numbers as called. We don't guarantee these are correct. 3-1, 2, 4, 6, 7, Race 8 at Wentworth Park. Globe Derby, Race 6. And Clever Son for Carol Watson, John Justice, the trainer driver. Two's on into three's on. We can update even further. Now 9-4 on. A stablemate of Rough and Tough to be driven by Scott Gill for Jason Kennedy in Victoria. 50-33-1. So some money for Rough and Tough. Dial a Buck, raced by Jeffrey Webster, the driver, Lance Justice, trainer, John Hawkes and Peter DeRusha, the owners. And Dial a Buck, 20-10-1. So halving its opening quote. Number four, Abby's Pride, 20-30-1. Kim Bray, 30-40. New Murdoch, number six, raced by the Blue Ribbon Syndicate. Lisa Justice takes the drive, and New Murdoch is into 16-1. So a couple of them have been backed here. Down to Blue Veil, number eight, is 18-33-1. Earl Nugent, number nine, racing for Bill Hartwig, and Ken and Ross Webb of Spring Gully Pickles in Victoria. Best of luck to you fellas. Delicatessen's Delight.
At Fanta Stakes, 26:45. The journey, it is a start. Now, Dialer Buck came out quickly and will try and head off Clever Son going to the first turn. He's about 2 metres clear, Dialer Buck. Kimbray just went a bit roughly back in the pack, but it's easing out of it. And round the first turn, Dialer Buck can't head off Clever Son, so the favourite drives up to lead. Rough and Tough is in behind them. Blue Veil, three back the rails as they slap quickly. Abby's Pride on the back there of Dialer Buck, which is dropping back looking for a trail. Earl Nugent around Kimbray now sneaking up along the inside, and New Murdoch was last. Down the back, Clever Son now just allowed to roll along a little faster. Out by about 8 metres, in second placing Rough and Tough, 6 metres to Blue Veil. Hanging right back, Dialer Buck. Kimbray has saved a lot of ground through on the inside. Abby's Pride was now third last and one off the rails. Second last, Earl Nugent. And New Murdoch was at the tail. Halfway around the top turn, Clever Son. The odds on favourite led 4 metres with just over 2.25 to run. Rough and Tough with the back of the leader second. And then in third placing on the rails, Blue Veil. Still Dialer Buck hanging back. And finally a trail is coming from Earl Nugent, which whips around them. Kimbray next on the inside, covered by Abby's Pride. And New Murdoch at the tail. Down to the judge, they've still got 2 laps left to run, and it's Clever Son on top, 4 metres clear, in second placing Earl Nugent. The lead time won't be particularly quick. It's only 1:22.8, that's fairly slow. On the outside, Earl Nugent, in behind them, Rough and Tough. Now Dialer Buck's got the 1-1. Blue Veil is bailed away on the inside next, on its outside in turn, then Abby's Pride a couple of metres back. Kimbray the rails and New Murdoch last of all. Racing down the back, under a lap and 3/4 to run. The leader is Clever Son, still 4 metres the good of Earl Nugent, which is going to have to work for a long way. On the rails, Rough and Tough. Dialer Buck now getting the trail, but of course it was outside the leader early. Then Blue Veil still next on the inside, moving up around at Abbey's Pride. And now the last pair of New Murdoch and Kimbray together. Halfway around the top turn, just over a lap and 1/4 left to run, and still the leader was Clever Son. It's had a fairly good run, did a little bit of work to hold the lead, but the sectional times since haven't been particularly quick, and it's only had to run 32-1 that quarter. 2 metres, Earl Nugent now starting to move up on the outside and apply a little bit of pressure to Clever Son. 5 metres away then to Dialer Buck. On the inside in turn, Rough and Tough, but it's off the bit. Next, Abby's Pride. Now, Blue Veil with the head turned to one side on the inside, and then New Murdoch and Kimbray at the tail. They race to the back, 700 out. Clever Sun and Earl Nugent. There's only a metre between them. They've spared right up now. 6 metres away then to Dial-a-Buck. 30.1 was the second quarter. Rough and Tough losing ground. Abby's Pride trying to go forward. Further back in the field then to Blue Vale. New Murdoch comes three deep and Kimbray. They're about to go to the 400. Clever Sun led. Earl Nugent trying hard to get on terms. Think Clever Sun might be going a little better though because he's getting a bit more busy now on Earl Nugent. 4 metres further back in the field then Dial-a-Buck and Abby's Pride both starting to make some ground. Clear then of Blue Vale and Kimbray on the turn. Now Clever Sun starts to get away from Earl Nugent. Third quarter 29.1. In fact, he goes for home, Clever Sun. He got 8 metres on Earl Nugent. Down the outside, Abby's Pride battling away Dial-a-Buck, but he'll be too good, Clever Sun. He races on to win clearly. About 8 metres, Earl Nugent battled it right out second. 3 metres away, Abby's Pride. They are followed in by Dial-a-Buck, Blue Vale, clearer of Kimbray, New Murdoch, and last home was Rough and Tough.
Race 6 at Globe Derby, 1-9-4. Well, there were a few tired old chasers there. Clever Son, John Justice, what a night he's having. In fact, between them, John and his brother Lance have won 5 of the 6 races. A treble to John, the last 3. Tip Top Prince, Barossa Baron, and now Clever Son racing for Carol Watson. Good luck to you, Carol. Pleased to see you in the winner's list. Carol has spent a lot of money in the harness racing game and come up with a very good 4-year-old here by Windshield Wiper out of the maternal family of Dark Paul. Mooney Valley, race 7. Kiwi Empress is 50-40. This is the Wangaratta Trophy final. Final night. Nationalpreneur 15-20 and Caramba 15-16. Extra View 7-2. Out to 11-2 and Vidal's Joy 14-15. I Fell In 6-7. Ronzel Joy 25-35. Genial Joe 13-2. Out to 8-1. Over the page we go to number 10 and that is Kentucky Rancher 7's in a little to 13-2. And Fella's Pride. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. For the Langs of Melton 2. Into 5-4. The tip here is number 7, and that is Eiffel Inn. And Eiffel Inn, of course, is sired by Touradeon, a Nero horse, to beat 11, Fellas Pride, and 9, Genial Joe. 7, 11, and 9, race 7 at Mooney Valley. That race is 4 minutes away, running a little late for the next at Penrith. We'll take a short commercial break and then to Darren Flindell for race 10, the last.
Sweet bar, sweet, warmer, sweet drinks don't mix. It's the only place I can get.
Penrith race 10, the red light will soon turn to green for the Riverlands Trophy heat number 3. The tip is number 2, duty performed. Indeed, for Darren Flindell.
7-4 on the tote, it's been a good go on the tote. The Victorian, they're off. Duty Perform bounced out well. It's up looking for the lead from Sorted and Magnetician, and Duty Perform's going to run clear. Out by 3 lengths to Sorted and Smart Tactics, followed by Magnetician Crescent. Getting flattened there, Chief Animator from She Made It and Concealed Weapon, and also decked was Crescent. Into the back and the Victorians well clear. Duty Perform out by 6 lengths to Sorted. 3 off to She Made It, starting to run home well. Further back, Concealed Weapon, Smart Tactics and Chief Animator, but coming onto the turn and Duty Perform still 6 in front from Sorted. Then She Made It. It gets around the last turn safely clear. Duty Performed, and it's going to win the last. Duty Performed by 5 lengths to She Made It. Sorted ran third, followed by Smart Tactics, Concealed Weapon, Magnetician, and the last one to finish was Chief Animator.
Well, Penrith race 10, the numbers 2, 5, and 1. Duty Performed, She Made It, and Sorted. 2, 5, and 1 race 10 at Penrith. Darren Flindell, thank you for your help. Have a happy new year and don't drink too much through the week. 36-50 was the time. 2, 3, and 1. I beg your pardon. My mistake there. Magnetician was second. Race
2, showing early speed is Caramba. On its outside, Extra View goes forward. It's hopping though for a stride there, losing ground. Now it's broken, Extra View. Came back and flattened Fella's Pride for a stride or two. Fellas Pride, he dropped out of it. He lost about 12 metres at that point. And as they travel off the back, Ronzel Joy, four out. Extra View, three out, goes forward. So too does Carumba. And back on the inside for the moment, Kiwi Empress keeps them all out. They're all over the shop on the turn the first time. Then National Predator working up on the outside now as they travel down the straight the first time at the 1800 is Verdale's Joy, as Ronzel Joy now takes over. Then Genial Joe, Eiffel in Kentucky Rancher, and Fellas Pride getting going as one off the fence. And last, two circuits out, in front Ronzel Joy by 5 metres to Extra View, who comes off the fence once again. Verdale's Joy having no luck at all, racing three wide, then Carumba the centre. Kiwi Empress on the rail, 6 metres away National Preneur, followed by Eiffel in, who races three wide there for a stride, followed by Genial Joe, Fellas Pride, and last is Kentucky Rancher. Along the back straight they head, and Fellas Pride, he tried to poke up between Eiffel in and Kentucky Rancher, found some bother for a stride or two. Again, he lost about 4 metres at that point. At the lap and a half mark, Ronzel Joy leads Extra View by a neck. 4 metres away on the outside is Carumba, having a nice run. On the leader's back is Kiwi Empress, followed by Verdale's Joy, who's been three wide from the outset. National Preneur in the centre. 6 metres away, Genial Joe. A break of 15 metres to Kentucky Rancher. 8 metres away, Fellas Pride. And Eiffel in dropped out to the tail, back on the rail. In the straight now, 1,000 to go. The action has been on from the outset. And Extra View now took over from on the outside, Carumba. Out three wide is Verdale's Joy, still there. Ronzel Joy is gone. Then National Preneur in the centre. Genial Joe now pulls out three wide on the back of Verdale's Joy. Kiwi Empress comes off the rail. Fellas Pride now pulls out three wide on the back of Genial Joe from Kentucky Rancher Eiffel Inn. And Ronzel Joy will be lucky to complete the course. Out of the straight they race towards the 650. Extra View being joined now by Carumba on the outside. Verdale's Joy still three out. Genial Joe trailing it, followed by National Preneur having a nice run. Fellas Pride will have to pull out six wide. He now pulls to the outside. He's warming up to the task. Extra View gone. Carumba gone. In front, Verdale's Joy. It's had no luck at all, though, by 3 metres to Genial Joe. Fellas Pride now pulls to the outside, gets to third. National Preneur checked for a stride from Kentucky Rancher running home, and the rest are well and truly beaten. But around the turn, 220 metres out, Verdale's Joy in front. It's had no luck at all. It's a neck in front of Genial Joe. 3 metres away, Fellas Pride still running home. At the 120, Genial Joe got to Verdale's Joy, but now Fellas Pride is knuckling down on the outside. He's had no luck, Fellas Pride. He ranged up to tackle Genial Joe. He put his nose in front, showing his true colours tonight, Fellas Pride. Fellas Pride wins a metre and a half to Genial Joe. 8 metres away, third, Verdale's Joy, a big effort. Then Kentucky Rancher. In behind them, National Preneur. A long way back, Carumba, Extra View, Eiffel in. Last in was Kiwi Empress. And the other one, Ronzel Joy, well, she was pulled up at the 600.
11, 9 and 5, race 7 at Moonee Valley. That was the horse we told you about, the Big Tote Tumble. I told you what Graham Lang said in the Australian Standard Bred just before the race. Hope you might have been able to jump aboard. Pretty easy.
Racing Fox's Fortune bounced out well, getting away well, Bogan Breeze. It led on settling down and showing plenty of pace. Bogan Breeze the leader, Milton moving to second now as they swing to the back. They're followed by Baby Maker, well back now as Brute's Moment. Then Fox Fortune on the rail, the next one was Mystery Babe, and they're followed by Curus and still running back at the tail. Out of the back straight up to the turn now, and the leader is Bogan Breeze turning the corner. The yellow Milton is coming home well and flashing home the blue Baby Moko. But Bogan Breeze went to the line and it's won the race in a very close finish from Milton. Rattling home there was Baby Mako, and they're followed just behind them then by still running Mystery Babe and Brute's Moment, about one of the last.
Race 9 at Wentworth Park, 6-5-4 and counting down. A Bogan Breeze was the winner, 6-5-4, race 9 at Wentworth Park at Newcastle. From Fine Time 5 and 7, Aurelio, here's Newcastle.
Out deep. And is charging forward in that early speed battle, followed by To Win Again over on the inside. Out deep, Rainbow Harpy pressing forward, going to the first corner. I'm a goodness in between horses, and then came Twice a Gin, followed by He's the Boss over on the inside as they go around the first corner. I'm Alone Hanover is a long way back in the field, and so too is President. Back second last at Inventory is at the tail of the field. Around the corner, they'll get the bell at the judge this time, and Red Mail Road is the leader. Turned the bend about a length and a half. Law and Order slipping over onto the fence behind the leader, and a length and a half to win again in third spot. Followed by I'm a Gooden going up on the outside, the first without cover. He's the Boss making ground along the fence, and then Twice a Gin. Followed at the head of the others by Rainbow Harpy as they go by the judge, and a length to I'm Alone Hanover. President is back second last, and last of all is Inventory. They've got the bell heading to the turnout of the straight, and Red Mile Road is setting a solid speed in front. Lead time is 61.5. It leads by a length and a half to I'm a Good, and moving up a little bit closer and a length further back to Laura Norda. A length and a half to Win Again over on the inside of Twice a Gen, followed by He's the Boss. President is taking off from the tail of the field with a big run out three wide, and then Rainbow Harpy followed by I'm Alone Hanover, and Inventory is at the tail of the field heading on towards the top corner. 400 metres left to go, and Red Mile Road is just about joined by I'm a Gooden on the outside, and they're about two clear of Law and Order, and here's President around the outside sustaining that long run, followed by To Win Again. Forget the others as they come to the bend. About 300 metres left to go, and I'm a Gooden took the lead. It's I'm a Gooden about a length in front of Red Mile Road. President on the outside about to join in three and four wide as they straighten. 200 metres left to go. I'm a Gooden looks to be travelling all right. Kicked away about two in front of Laura Norda. President can't go on down the outside. I'm a Gooden's in front. He's having a good look. He's driving it confidently, and I'm a Gooden is going to score. I'm a Gooden first, second To Win Again. Third home was Laura Norda, followed by President. At the head of the others, Red Mile Road. Then came Inventory, out deep on the track, making up some ground. Then was Rainbow Harpy, followed by He's the Boss. And a long way back towards the tail was Twice a Gen.
Race 9 at Newcastle, 5, 2 and 7 family favourites there. The big banger breeder, Ron Crogan, from Bangaroo Stud at St Mary's. Racing the winner, Ronnie's had a lot of success with Trooping and Knight's Tailor, the gallopers recently.
Penultimate race of the night. Second last race for the year here at the Creek. Lights on, racing, and Aurelio absolutely burnt out of the gate. Went lickety-split through the first 100 metres and charged to the lead. Chancey Scott zooms up on the outside, Fine Time third, Dominionaire fourth on the rail, and Maori Fellas between them. Two and a half to Herbie Belmont, two lengths to Syracuse, around Suru King, burnt off in the early part. Second last is Hoity Toll, and Virgo Byrne drop back to the tail of the field. Aurelio the leader at the end of the first quarter by more than a length over Dominionaire, and Fine Time still wide now working up to the death. Chancey Scott fourth, Maori Fellow fifth, a length and a half to Suru King, one to Herbie Belmont on the outside. Then Hoity Toll on the rail on the inside of Syracuse, and Virgo Byrne's last, 28.2 the first split. Aurelio takes them to the back after the bell. 900 left to run. It's Aurelio by more than a length over Fine Time, who has to do it tough. Dominionaire third behind the leader. Suru King locked up on the rail. Chancey Scotty stablemate sweet seating. Hoity Toll's on the fence inside of Maori Fella. Two lengths to Herbie Belmont. Virgo Byrne's off. He's three deep going forward past the tea trees, and Syracuse will peel and tag him. Aurelio leads at the 600. They slowed to 32.5 in the second quarter. Dominionaire's off the fence. Fine Time and a loose rein now. He couldn't go with them again. Suru King sticking to the rail. He needs an out. Then Chancey Scott, Hoity Toll, Virgo Byrne, Syracuse, Maori Fella, Herbie Belmont. Aurelio a neck in front at the 300. Dominionaire's on his outside. Suru King sweating on a run. Fine Time still got him in a pocket, and then Virgo Byrne. Aurelio in front at the top of the lane. Over Dominionaire. Fine Time picks up the bit again. Suru King's climbing over their backs. Aurelio in front with 100 left to go. Aurelio leads. Fine Time's trying hard, but it's Aurelio. Aurelio from go to woe, beating Fine Time and the unlucky Suru King. Then Dominionaire, Chancey Scott, and Hoity Toll. Syracuse, Virgo Byrne, Herbie Belmont, and Maori Fellow was last of all.
The placings there, 7, 5 and 1 Aurelio.
He lets them go. Filbert Street trotted out safely enough. Oh, Totem Toto has been tipped out. Driver's been tipped out of the cart. It and Finance Man have got tangled up. Shot Over has stayed there on the mark. It refuses to go. My word, what a terrible start. Filbert Street is the early leader by 4 metres in second placing Outrage. Top coverage actually kept three deep by Outrage. 6 metres further back in the field then to Profile. 8 metres next along in the field then Lord Crest. About 30 metres to another report in Ardeus. Oh, Evander Rose broke up. That's the end of him. So four of them are out of the race by the first turn. Evander Rose, Finance Man, Shot Over and Totem Toto. Didn't really see what happened at the start. Perhaps hang on to tickets for the moment. Outrage is going to the front. Outrage goes 4 metres clear now. In second placing, Filbert Street. 4 metres away, top coverage. About 10 or 12 metres to Profile. They've gone pretty hard early. Another 6 metres next along then, Lord Crest. Still 35 metres back in the pack then to another important 4 metres then to Ardius. Nearly 100 metres of Van der Rose for getting the rest, and Totem Toto's taken no part basically. Into the straight they come, and still 2 1/4 from home, and the leader is Outrage. Outrage by 4 metres in second placing top coverage. Filbert Street in behind them, and Profile lands with the 1-1 trail right on its back, Lord Crest. Another report, and Ardius have made no ground at all on the leading pack. And then I think we can already forget about Evander Rose and the other three. They race past the mile. 127.3 was the lead time. Doesn't mean a lot from the stand, because we don't know too much from the stand. But the leader is Outrage by a couple in second placing top coverage, working away. Well, the favourite Profile's had a lovely run. Filbert Street is on the rails. Then Lord Crest. Now the other pair are making up some ground. They got within about 20 metres, another report on Ardius. And we will forget about the other four. Shot Over is 3/4 of a lap nearly behind them. They race off the back, a lap and a half from home. And the pilot is Outrage. It's a neck in front in second placing top coverage. Profile is in the 1-1 trail, Filbert Street in behind them, then Lord Crest, and 6 metres away to Ardius on the outside of another report. Now the first quarter, 32.4, they straighten up for the bell, and it's Outrage, a metre in front of top coverage, which has been doing all the work in the run. On the outside, Profile will have no excuses, the favourite. Filbert Street's in behind them, Lord Crest on the back of Profile, and then further back another report, and on its outside, Ardius, as they race towards the back straight. They've got just on 700 metres left to run, and Outrage going pretty well. Nearly 4 metres, it's got away from top coverage. Profile around the outside, Filbert Street's losing ground, 31.7 the second quarter, as Outrage is trying to outsprint them down the back, then Lord Crest. The leader is Outrage, here comes Profile, he's very quickly trotting up. He gets within 3 metres, now 2, and he's about to join the leader. They're clear of top coverage, and further back, Lord Crest, still a place hope from Filbert Street off the back. Outrage and Profile together again. Outrage joined now by Profile. 20 metres top coverage, Lord Crest, and then Filbert Street on the turn, 200 out. Profile gets a couple of metres on Outrage, which is trying hard to go with it. They went 29.6 the third quarter, but Profile's going to race away on the straight. Outrage is very tight. In fact, he's going roughly, and Profile wins in a walk. Profile wins by 15 metres or more on the line. Outrage second, 20 metres Lord Crest, then top coverage Filbert Street, a gap then to another report Ardius, a long gap of Van der Rose, a long gap Finance Man, and it is still a half a lap away then to a Shot Over, who just wouldn't go at the start, and Totem Toto losing the driver right at the start.
3, 2 and 5, the placings there. Good trot of that fella Profile, the toe tumbler. Ray Goble has turned him out perfectly. 4 wins from 5 starts this season. 3, 2 and 5, race 7 at Globe Derby. They're all set for race 10. Hold all tickets at Globe Derby, incidentally. Hold all tickets there. An announcement from the stewards. Race 10, the Auld Lang Syne Stake at Wentworth Park. Happy New Year, Ray Conroy.
Thanks, same to you, Mas. They're getting in for the final event. Green light showing, away goes the bunny. And they'll soon be racing, soon be jumping. Racing, Startling Osti wasn't the smartest out, missing the kick El Kabur. On Settling Down is a great race for the lead, but Little Destructo showing pace now has got to the lead. They're followed then moving around and Big Bad Brutus. And the next one, Startling Osti, El Kabur. They're followed by Super Mocker on the rail. And well back now is Beach Gown, Larissa Bell. And Big Bad Stop out of the back straight now. And Big Bad Stop turns the corner nicely clear. One danger, Little Destructo, but Big Bad Stop is going to win. Big Bad Stop first, Little Destructo a second, Startling Osti third, and they're followed home then by Super Mocker. The next to finish, Beach Gown, Larissa Bell, and the last couple of finish was El Kabur and Little Destructo. No, not Little Destructo. It's run second, I'm hot, that's it.
You're hot, all right, and when you're hot, you're hot, and when you're not, you're not. Ray Conroy, thanks for your help this year. 8, 2 and 5, race 10 at Wentworth Park, and very safe driving back up to the Central Coast. Ray, you have a great week. 8, 2 and 5, race 10, and Ray sent us home on a winner this year. You beauty, Big Bad Strop, the toe tumbler. Hold all tickets at Globe Derby, please.
Set. Racing. Well, they were very much all over the shop shortly after the start. Barford getting it right, who pinged straight to an early lead. Out of its gear is Illawong Andrew early. Feel the Heat is out the back and galloping. Tender Approach gets to second. Linden Skipper third. Illawong Andrew now hitting its traps as fourth. Getting it right as buckled out of the straight. The driver of Linden Skipper has been tipped out of the cart. Easy Dollars has gone over the top of it. And over the top of the pair is Pinball Machine. The specialist was TKO'd. And they're all over the shop out of the straight. Down the back of the 1500. Nitronamo left 25 metres in front of Illawong Andrew. 30 metres away, third Tender Approach, then Motorship, 15 metres to Getting It Right, 10 metres away, the Specialist, 35 metres away, Camelot Girl. Feel the Heat has been pulled up out of the race. The driver of Pinball Machine is quite okay. The two lying on the track at the moment are Easy Dollars and M. Magri. M. Magri quite okay. The driver of Linden Skipper, Brian Rogers, he's quite okay. He's walked towards the inside section of the track. Now, as this field travel down the straight with a lap to go, they'll have to weave around the ambulance and also the two fallen horses, which are Linden Skipper and Easy Dollars. Travelling down the straight, they've got a lap to go at the 9.50. In front is Nitronamo by 20 metres to Illawong Andrew, 25 metres to Motorship. Then Getting It Right as they start to work around the ambulance and also the fallen horses. 8 metres away, the Specialist, followed by Tender Approach, and 120 metres away to Camelot Girl. The other one distance in the race is Feel the Heat. They've got around the ambulance and the fallen horses quite okay. The driver of Pinball Machine, Robert Casia, he's walked to the outside section of the gallop track. Easy Dollars and M. Magri, the driver's okay, and Lyndon Skipper and Brian Rogers. Both horses on the track at the moment, but Brian Rogers has walked to the inside section of the track and he appears to be okay. Still Nitronamo comes to the 400 metre mark by 25 metres to the Specialist and also Getting It Right, then Motorship, and 100 metres away Illawong Andrew. Getting It Right has broken once again. He's come back and he's flattened Motorship. They've locked wheels, but have a look at the Specialist. He's lost a tremendous amount of ground. He's raising a Herculean performance, the Specialist. He's coming out after Nitronamo at the 100. Nitronamo 4 metres in front. The Specialist, he's veering in, veering out. He switches back to the rail, making ground. It's Nitronamo in front though, and Nitronamo had the race presented to him. He wins by 3 metres to the Specialist. 120 metres away, third was Getting It Right. Fourth in was Motorship. Fifth in Illawong Andrew. Sixth in Camelot Girl. Last in and seventh Tender Approach. What a sensational freshman classic. Feel the Heat was pulled up. The ones that came to grief were Pinball Machine Robert Casia, along with Easy Dollars M. Magri and Linden Skipper Brian Rogers.
Now, race 8 at Moonee Valley, the numbers were 3, 10 and 6. Nitronamo, the Specialist, and Getting It Right. I have no doubt it will be called a race. Hold all tickets just in case, but no doubt it will be called a race. I'm sure that the fourth place getter will get third on protest. Motorship will get third on protest from Getting It Right. But anyway, here's the fall. Getting It Right just ducked out. Look, he knows as much about racing as pigs do about white shirts, Getting It Right, because he was all over the place and crash, bang, wallop, they've come down over the top. Look at the Specialist on the outside fence. He's the horse in the green colours. Brian Gath, not Gator Pulicino, it was Brian Gath, nearly pulled into a standstill, got round the outside of those horses and ran the leader, who had 50 or 60 metres on him, ran into about 3 metres. The Specialist, you reckon he's not a good horse? Now, Getting It Right flattened half of them there, including Motorship. I believe that Motu is a type of language in New Guinea. The time was 2:32.4. That was a race time, be very slow mile rate there, and you saw what happened. It was